Good evening, everyone. Welcome. I am Martin Mueller. I am the Dean of the School of Jazz, College of Performing Arts here at the New School. I'm very proud to welcome you to a very special night. This is the second public event of a year-long residency that we are fortunate to have with the amazing Randy Weston. And tonight, Randy, along, of course, with Master Abdellah El Gourd, will bring us just a little bit, hopefully a lot, into the musical and spiritual journey of the Gnawa, these incredible musicians and healers in the traditional music of Morocco. We are fortunate to have these incredible musicians all the way from Tangiers to be with us tonight. So this is sort of a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity for many of our students. Hopefully not for you all, but this is a really unique and special opportunity tonight. And we will introduce them all to you, of course, in just a moment, but we'd like to open up the evening with a video from a festival in Berlin, I believe it's 1991, with Randy performing with Gnawa musicians from both Tangiers and Marrakesh, which are two different communities of the Gnawa, but together in this moment in shared collaboration and spirit. And Randy and I agree, feels this is a wonderful introduction to this community and its music. So again, a warm welcome to you all. And we're going to begin with the video and enjoy the evening, and we'll be right back. Yeah. Everybody got their cell phones turned off? Thank you. Hey. Nice to see some special friends in the audience here tonight. So, we are now going to, really get into the truths, the live truths, with these incredible artists to talk and to play and to learn a little bit more about this incredible experience, the Gnawas. So what we want to do, without further ado, is to ask you to please help me welcome to the stage Randy Weston, and from Tangiers, Master Abdellah El Gourd and the ensemble Dar Gnawa, with his son Abdul Jabbar El Gourd, Khalid Rohali, and Noureddin Tuati.
That's it. Yeah, okay.
It's going to be a spiritual night because we have the spiritual brothers of Morocco, of Africa. And the continent itself produces a certain magic, and music that comes out of Africa is the magic of Africa itself, you know. And there's always that feeling of spirit and pulse in Africa, you know. And the music sort of goes like this, you know, and it's a tune to heart, tune to soul, taking you on a beautiful level through music. And I'm so happy to have with me, I met this gentleman in 1967 in Tangier, and I was looking for the oldest music I can find. When I ever go to Africa, I look for the oldest people, I look for the oldest music, because when you do that, you're getting closer to what the ancient African empires must have been like before Africa was invaded from the north, you see. So they have great skills, great things about music. So I met this gentleman through a teacher at a school in Tangier. He said to me, "Mr. Weston, I heard you like traditional music. Have you ever heard Gnawa?" I said, "No." He said, "I'm going to bring the Gnawa by your house." I said, "Great." I had a small apartment with my children, my dad, and whatnot. And Abdellah El Gourd, he came with this instrument that's called a hajuj. And he sat down, and he started to play this instrument. And it hit me, if you could imagine what this must have been for me as a youngster, to hear the Jimmy Blanton string bass with the Ellington Orchestra. See, before Jimmy Blanton, the bass was played da-da-da, doom-doom-doom, doom, et cetera. But Jimmy opened that up, that string instrument. So when I heard this instrument, I heard Jimmy Blanton. It was just instant love. He introduced me to some of the Gnawa masters, those who came from Africa below the Sahara, who were taken to Morocco as soldiers, some in slavery and whatnot, to help to restore order at that particular time. And they got together of African people from different parts of Africa. Abdellah El Gourd, he said, like Chad, like different countries would come up north, you know, and they produce the music. That is so powerful and so beautiful, has made a tremendous impact upon myself, my family, and a greater knowledge of what is African music, because this is the origin of what we do. African music is as old as Africa itself. The ancient African empires, they had all kinds of musical instruments. The ancient Egyptian had schools of music. If you go down the Nile, you go on in the area, you see those incredible monuments with all musical instruments. Drums, string bass, you see everything there, the origin of music. So Abdellah, I know I want to say a lot, but I want to get you into the picture, please. Would you be kind enough to tell everybody what is the origin of Gnawa, please?
Assalamu alaikum. The origin, my origin of Gnawa. Well, Gnawa is the origin of all the black magician in Morocco. And this music is created at the epoch of Moulay Ismail. From this time, they start create the repertoire. Now, thanks to them, we have a repertory very big. It supports 240 sounds, composed over 12 colors, 7 original and 5 complementary. And we play with 3 instruments. The first is the tambour, we call it a tabol. And the second is the karkaba, the croquet. And the third is the hajhuj, the African guitar. And also we sing and we dance. And we celebrate a ceremony, but a big ceremony every year, 1 month before the Ramadan.
And in addition, to be a master in traditional society as Gnawa, you not only had to be able to play your instrument well, but you had to be respected by the community. You had to be pure of mind and heart, because you're going to be able to help to cure people through music, make people happy through music. Have people come together through music, music for food, music for a baby being born, music for a funeral. But the whole concept of music in Africa, everybody is music. And we retain that here, because I can never forget getting my shoes shined in Brooklyn, and a kid was shining my shoes whistling Charlie Parker's solo. And he wasn't a musician. But African people, music is extremely important. It's the first language. But what you're going to hear tonight, music of Africa itself, the Gnawa people. Abdellah, would you play one song for us with the group?
Thank you. يا غوا على هاد الحالة مرحبا بكم أو حال حالة يا لي الله غمضورا نعماليكم بشيرا السلام عليكم انتم يا خوا مرحبا بكم هاي هاد الحالة
We have a young Gnawa joining us, Samir, and we're just going to have a little conversation about this music. I mean, what is it? What is it? And it's so beautiful. And all the music is spiritual. All the songs are spiritual. And when you hear this music, you become in contact with the Creator. You come in contact with the galaxies. Like ancient times when people were, music was also in the earth, also up there. Well, Samir, we were talking today about the music. Ask Abdellah about the hajuj. You can do it on the mic.
الهجوج من أصل واحد شجرة والشجرة مقطعة على جوج ومحفورة من الوسط بالعربية ولا بالإنجليزية ما فهمش إنجليش والما يسمون هجوج is from one trip and cut it in a middle and covered with the skin of the camel, and has a bridge whose support the string from the goat owner of the intestine. This is and we play with it by fingers.
Yeah, so Mr. Abdullah was talking about the, like a tree, and then we cut it from the middle, and then we empty it, and we have the body, and then we cover it with the skin, and then we have the strings are made of goat guts, and then we have the bridge, and we have an instrument. And this is just one of the three instruments we have.
وقديم بزاف من الايام ديال السود اللي كانوا في اللي خلقوا هذا الميدان هذا.
Yeah, and this is from the black people like who created this this music.
انا عندنا كذلك القرقبه اللي معموله من المجي الاصل ديالها من السناسيل التي كانت كتشبر الكرعين والعبيد اللي كانوا يقدفوا بديك الباخره. فالصوت ديال كركتو ولا الحباري مثلا في الميدان الجنوي ما يجي من ديك الخيال هذاك اللي جازوا فيه العبيد.
Yeah, and we also have the castanets that are made of the metal like we have in here. Which is قرقبه. And the history of it is like when the slaves they used to have the cuffs on their hands on the feet or like their hands. So that's how they create the thought about creating the castanets out of that.
وكذلك عندنا الطبول اللي هي كلعبوا بهم فيها جنجا والفرادي وهذوك الطبول مغلفين من اصل شجره كذلك قطع من اللوح وفي نفس الوقت مستديره تحمل غلافا من الجلد المعيز الانثى والذكر وتربط بحبل يستديرها كلها وفي نفس الوقت تلعب بعمود من الخشب بيدين
تفضل. And we also have the drum which is made of wood and the goat skin the female and the male like one side is a female one side is a male so and then we use it with the we play it with like sticks with the wood sticks and they have like a so it's a they like this you know they're not straight.
وكذلك عدنا الغناء وفي نفس الوقت عدنا الرقص فهذوك بجوج بهم نعبر بهم الأيام الماضية اللي دجوا فيها الأجداد وعاشوا فيها بهذه المراحل وهذه كلها مراحل للناس اللي مضات واللي خلقت هذا الميدان وخلته الى يومنا هذا بالمغرب.
And we also have a dance and we have singing to go back to the old days. That's why like whatever we sing and we dance we dance and we sing about our history and back to the old days and you know remembering the family and the friends.
وبهذه الآلات نحيي الدردبة ما يقال عن ليلة وهي ماشي ليلة بل دردبة التي تحيا كل سنة وهذه الدردبة تطالب يومين في مدتها العادية والتقليدية.
And with all of this we celebrate like a Gnawa night which is a دردبة and we celebrate it like it takes 2 days for celebration 2 days of celebration.
وهذه الليلة تتحمل 240 قطعة في الطريقة الجناوية اللي عندنا موروثة في المغرب وخاصة بشمال المغرب.
And this whole like it's they play 240 songs.
40.
And 40 songs for the whole repertory.
Supported over 12 colors. 7 original and 5 complementary during all ceremony.
Mm. You know, it's what we call the first time. We're all getting together. But the whole idea is just to get inside the traditional music of Africa and how everything is so put together so beautifully to reach the human soul, to reach that kind of taking music and lifting us up spiritually, you know. And when I first heard this music, that's what happened to me. I said, wow, that's my music. But when I heard this music, I heard the blues, I heard the jazz, I heard the black church all at the same time. And for me, my life is wanting to find out, I've very been interested in African culture, African people all my life, you know. For my father, he insisted that I study the great African civilizations, you know, and which I did as a boy, and listening to traditional music and talking to people, asking questions and whatnot. But it means that it's like you see a beautiful tree, a gorgeous tree, you know. You don't see the root of that tree. But the root is Africa for music. It's the root of, certainly in the Western Hemisphere, call it pop, hip-hop, jazz, samba, bossa nova. It's that African pulse that's so special. And when they play, it's that it's pulse. It goes, and it's Mother Africa, because she's like that. She was like that before man ever arrived. So, Abdellah, would you play another song, please?
Another song.
Yes, please. And then I'm going to play it a little bit. And some of the things that I wrote when I lived in Morocco by being with the traditional people. So I've done another Gnawa song.
يوبادي يا شو شندي حمادي يكبى يكبى صباصي يا شو شندي
يوبادي
يوبادي يوبادي يا يوبادي يوبادي يا شو شندي صباصي يكبى يكبى حمادي يا تشاندي
يوبادي يوبادي
يوبادي
الله وكبر
يوبادي
الله
وكبر
لا يوبادي
يا تشاندي أو لا إله إن الله تفعنا حبيب الله
يوبادي الله
وكبر
لا يوبادي
يا تشاندي يوبادي يكبر يكبر حمادي يا تشاندي
يا الحبيب
يا
يا
Abdellah, describe the songs. Tell us what the songs are all about, please.
There are too many songs, too many titles for each repertoire of the colors. But right now I play, we call it Wulad Bambara, the son of Bambara. And the son of Bambara, it doesn't mean Bambara language in Mali. It means another thing, like a nickname in Morocco. Black, the child of the black Gnawas. Hey, that is what you call a Gnawa, Wulad Bambara. And also, only in Wulad Bambara we have 52 sounds. It takes more than 3 or 4 hours. And after that, we enter to the spirituality. Yeah. Please.
Samir, you're a young Gnawa. Express how you feel the culture, like you do, and the importance of keeping it going.
For me, like the Gnawa is, it's like, it's something that I have to listen to and feel. And now just being here and hearing like Maalem Abdellah El Gourd and all the bands and you, Mr. Randy, you know, having us all together here, it just makes me so happy and, you know, I'm so proud to be here tonight.
Thank you so much, Samir. It's a spiritual night. I'm going to go to the piano and run through some of the songs that I've written in Morocco, but influenced not only by Gnawa, but there's another powerful group called the Jilala, also Hamacha, going down the Sahara Desert. And because you see what happens is that the music is created based upon the environment. So if you go to Sahara Desert, you can get music of the Sahara. That's going to be the foundation. If you go to the forest is going to be the foundation, or the savannah. But this music comes directly out of the earth and takes you to the sky. So I'm going to play a couple of songs with my experience in Morocco. Thank you. It was 3 o'clock in the morning in the city of Rabat, and I was in a hotel room. Only been to Morocco maybe 6-7 months, something like that, you know. And the Medina is incredible during the day. That's where you have all the incredible vegetables and fruit. I mean, this country is so rich with agriculture, it blew your mind. You bite it on a potato, you get the real taste of the potato. But so I was writing some music, and someone said to me, go over to the Medina at 3 o'clock in the morning, have that experience. So being from Bed-Stuy, you know, I was a little crazy, but I said, I'm going to do it anyhow. And I went to the Medina, and all I saw was shadows, you know. It was mysterious, but it was beautiful. I called this piece Night in the Medina. Thank you. Thank you. In Tangier, you know, you can see Spain on a special day on the other side, you know. And the sun is very big and very beautiful. So this is a piece I call Tangier Bay. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. It was, we were traveling, you know, because you go to Africa, you want to see what's going on. We travel on around, and I ran across this Berber village. It's called Imentanout, not far from Rabat going south, you know. And I heard this beautiful music, you know. And so it inspired me all the way to Marrakesh. So I call this piece of Marrakesh blues, but it's really inspired by some of the Berber music I heard in Morocco, because the country is so rich in culture. I mean, all kinds of different kinds of music, instruments. I mean, when they had a festival years ago, they invited musicians to come on camels, on horseback, all kind of drums, you know, and taking the African rhythms, but everybody doing something different. It's mind-blowing. Anyhow, for my last soul number, this is Marrakesh Blues. I want to share with you a little bit of a ceremony that I experienced with the Gnawa music. Now, with their music, they do acrobats, they dance, they eat fire, they tell stories, they're historians. But then they have those special spiritual get-togethers where they deal with the colors. And in their tradition, every human being has a color, every human being has a note, a sound. And when your sound is off, that means you're not very healthy. So they have this spiritual process of bringing you back to Mother Nature, because they say what's very basic and very true. When you're sick, you're out of tune with Mother Nature. So the whole idea is to bring you back. And we're all musical instruments. Your heart is your drum. Your voice is your sound. So we're all connected. And with the high master musicians, such as Abdellah El Gourd, to reach your soul, not your ears with the music, but to reach your soul, make your soul happy, make you lift up, you know, and say life is beautiful, music is beautiful. We hear all kinds of music. So anyhow, I learned on the piano one of the traditional Gnawa songs, which I'm going to play with you next, with the Gnawa. And in Arabic, it's called Sidi Musa. We call it Blue Moses, the color blue. Blue is my color. I didn't realize that till I spent time. We've been together 48 years when we first met. The spirit is met. And I can assure you, I know very little bit about this music. Why do I say that? Because it's coming out of the ancient tradition of music that the planets go around the earth, and each planet has got its own sound. Mercury's got a different sound than Jupiter. Saturn's got another kind of sound. And each planet has got its own rhythm, right? And then the planets are going around like this, you see. So they know that the original music came from the galaxies, came from the Creator. And the ancient Egyptians, those black people, people don't know about, they had a fantastic school of music in the Nile Valley civilization. Teaching, they had all the instruments. You look at the monuments, you see all the flutes and string instruments. You see this instrument 1,000 years ago, you know. And they set the foundation for music. But music as a healing force, music as a memory, you know. You heard certain songs, you may have heard 30, 40 years ago. But at that particular time when you heard that song, you felt something beautiful happen. You know, so they also keep a calendar of life. And in Morocco, when people, sometimes the houses are not happy. Sometimes you wake up and you don't feel good. And the walls, it just don't feel right, you know. They call the Gnawa people. And when they play their music, the walls are laughing, the ceiling is smiling. Because the music takes us all back to the very beginning of who we are as a humanity. Before Mother Nature decided to paint all the different colors that we all are. She's the artist, Mother Nature. She created the first orchestra, you see. So it's something that is so beautiful going back to the root of our music. And I tell students all the time, listen, go back as far as you can, you know. I was told the same thing in the Berkshires when I met Professor Marshall Stearns, and the first jazz scholar. And he said to me, listen to Jimmy Yancey. He said, listen to the oldest pianist you can find. I said, why would he say that, you know? That's what the great Max Roach, my dear friend. He said, Randy Weston, listen to Baby Dodds. I said, why would he say that? Max Roach is one of the master of what we call modern drumming. But his point was, those people in the 20s and 30s, they were closer to Africa. And it comes out in the music. That's why you never get a sound like Louis Armstrong. He may not play all the notes everybody plays, but he can take one note and reach your heart with his sound. Colvin Hawkins with his sound, Duke Ellington with his sound on the piano. And that's coming out of African tradition, because I'm convinced, since America is young as it is, we're very beautiful, but we're a very young country compared to older civilizations, you see. But wherever you find, in my experience, I'm always looking for African people. I want to know what they're doing. Not because I'm one of them, I'm just curious. Who are these folks? You know, and when I go, I see Brazil, there's samba and bossa nova there, and calypso, and Trinidad, and Jamaica, and reggae, and jazz, and bossa nova. How this all take place? Who was Louis Armstrong's great-great-grandmother, great-grandfather? For him to take that European instrument and create something so beautiful and so sensitive and set the foundation for our music, you see. But it comes up because the Gnawa people, they never left Africa. That's the difference, you see. So I feel we've lost some of the magic of our ancestors. Yeah, we got good musicians, don't misunderstand me. But the people close to the motherland, they had a spiritual connection, a spiritual concept of music, what it really is. You cannot have a cultural development without music. You can't take a music out of schools. Music is a vital part of education. Yeah. Because music is magic. You can't see music. You can't touch music. Where is it? When we play, where those notes go? They go inside each one of you, but after that, what happens? We don't know what happens. And that's why traditional people teach, they see the creator is a real musician. And we are instruments, those of us. And if we follow the tradition of our planet, our civilization, to realize where things began, which was in Africa. I've been years involved, and I know absolutely nothing. I'm like a baby. I would never be an expert in Africa, impossible, because you're dealing with the spirit of the motherland itself. You find South Africa, you find Zimbabwe, you find Morocco, you find whatever, Egypt, you find there's a certain pulse, and the pulse coming out of that continent itself. So what we try to do with Abdellah, myself, we try to bring the traditional rhythms. We try to bring you back how you were 5,000 and 10,000 years ago. No matter what your call looked like, forget about that. We all come from the same family. That's the big, come from the same family. And that's why music is our language, you see. So when the music touches our heart, you see. So Abdellah, I said all that to say this, that I had been with the Gnawa almost 2 years, but never to a real serious ceremony where they do the colors. And it's like in their society, each person has a color and a sound, and they do healing music. And when they do that, the people who are like that, they dress in the color. You dress in red, if red is your color. They have this one, music, or whatever. That's the way it works. So I went to see the chief, who I'd known 2 years, you see. And he was a wonderful man. And I said to him, I said, sir, I would like to attend the ceremony. He said, no. He said, you're not ready for that yet. I said, no, I feel like I've been working now. I want to get inside that spiritual power of that music. Now, all the music is about love. All the music is about love. Everything that happened with these people is spirit and love. See, that's what's so deep, you see. That's what it means. And I went there with a friend of mine. It started 4 o'clock in the afternoon to 6 o'clock in the morning. And I heard the color blue. And that color touched me when I heard this. I said, that's my color. I remember the great master, Duke Ellington, in his house in New York, his piano was painted blue. And of course, we're talking about blue, the blues, blue color. And so I'll never forget that experience, and I was almost like in a spiritual trance for about 2 weeks. The music took me up there somewhere where I'd never been, but it was very beautiful because music has that power. So Abdellah, let's do Sidi Musa. Yeah?
Yeah. Yeah, she did. Oh, yeah. 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 Yeah.
They talk about the weather.
This is a very natural instrument. It's tuned by saliva and the temperature. And it changes sometimes, you know. Yeah. But Abdellah El Gourd, you are a fantastic eunuch in our people. Yeah. Aren't they? Wow. And they're going to do one last number. And just to say, I hope that you enjoyed our collaboration. There's so much to learn about music. And keep that repertoire up. Students say to me, say, what do you do about music? I say, listen, I put on a tradition. And just let it play, you know. Could be Louis Armstrong, it could be Gnawa. Because the older music, the spiritual feeling is so powerful. Sometime in modern music, we're so busy being modern that we're not getting that thing, you know, that spirit. And we just... we've been together, like I said, 48 years of culture. Abdellah.
Yes, sir.
And I have to add this. I'm so sorry. I think our time is getting short, maybe. If you go to Tanger, Morocco, Abdellah has a beautiful cultural center of Gnawa culture. When I met him, he was already a historian. He made sure I met some of the older Gnawa who had taken and had to walk the Sahara Desert, or horse and whatnot. Incredible stories, you know. And so he has a beautiful cultural center. It's called Dar Gnawa. And it's big, it's beautiful, and you see all the various costumes of the Gnawa of years ago. You see photographs. At the same time, you see some jazz, you see Dizzy, you see Duke, you know. And he single-handedly, I know nobody in Morocco like this man. He's had about at least four or five centers of culture to make sure the Gnawa tradition stays alive, you see. Yeah. 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 You see, because we need that root. I don't care where you go, okay, how much money you make, how much you can talk about. When you got that root, that's the origin of all of us. How am I going to be greater than my mother and father? I can sell 1 billion records. I'll never be greater than them. Because they put that bottle in my mouth when I couldn't do nothing. Yeah, it's true. So when we connect, the past is also the future. Because that generation of musicians and my life in Tangier, I have to add very quickly, I had my own club in Tangier for 3 years. It was called the African Rhythms Club. And my son Azadine, who was a fantastic musician, he learned the Gnawa rhythms, brilliant artist. He helped me a lot in Tangier and Gnawa, and we established this club. And this club, we had a blues band from Chicago sometimes. Sometimes we have singers from the Congo singing in Lingala, one of the traditional languages of the Congo, or we have Gnawa. But the whole idea is to have a global approach of African culture. And when you look right here in America, you stop and say, what has Africa contributed to the United States? And if you look at it that way, your mind is blown. And us in music, I don't know where these people come from. Count Basie, Art Taylor, where do people come from making that beautiful, beautiful music? But it comes out of traditional Africa, because with the music is based upon spirituality, it's based upon love, it's based upon bringing people together. That's the whole key. Abdellah, we'll do one more short piece. Maybe they might want to take a trip and look at everybody, okay, and then we'll close. Do you follow me or whatever? There's something, whatever.
In Arabic, talk about what? Who is Gnawa? About myself. About Khadij. Last song. Excuse me.
Can you use me?
Excuse me, my language, English, it's super. I am not able to can to talk, to explain. Excuse me. Last song. I play Maniara for? Okay.
Yeah, 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 y نازوكم بالكلام عادي باي بغيت افرحكم يا حبايبي فخر وعاني وشوقنا حزين على فقدكم عادي باي ما ننادي يا خويا
اما يا خو
ولي يا ربكم عارف كانكم يشدنا لكم
يا يا
يا رب ويا خطير كون لكم عجيب حبالها ويا حبابي
أهلا لكم
يا حبابي ويا خطير
أهلا أخوكم
أفارقة ومربة
وعصرين لكم
هذا جبنا اللي فهمنا يشدنا لكم من قدر
يا مرحبا
يا رب
يا من يا رب وعرفنا ونشدنا ليه لطلق
يا الأباء يا حبابي وعطات الأجيال أخبركم طالبين بإيحة حبيبة
ونحبكم
المالي ويا خلق
أمان يا ربو
كل سني قال يا حبابي
أمان يا ربو
منكم الدبو يا خلق
أمان يا ربو
منكم سواهيلي يا حبابي
أمان يا ربو
منكم بالنيجر يا خلق
أمان يا ربو
يا حبيبي
أمان يا ربو
منكم الدبو يا خوز
أمان يا ربو
فلي يا رب تمعرف كمكم يخلق لكم من قدر
يا يا يا
أمان يا رب
أمان يا رب وعرف كانوا يشدنا لهم
من قدر إيمان يا رب ومعرف كانوا يشدنا لهم من قدر
أمان يا رب وعرف كانوا يشدنا لهم من قدر
وعهد بيننا من سمعت يا
Master Abdellah El Gourd and the Gnawa Ensemble and Randy Weston. Give it up, yeah.
This is Hassan. Is it on? Hello. Hello. Yes, we met his father. He's from Fez, you see. And they got another beautiful rhythm, Tanger, Casablanca. Wherever you go, you find Gnawa. And the music is all spiritual and beautiful. I want to thank the new school for inviting us. It's my first time as artist in residence here, and I hope everybody's happy.